Welcome to the Optimize Bubble Sort module. In this module, we're going to learn how to optimize the algorithm that we've already seen before. To do this, let's start with a given unsorted array. After running one iteration of bubble sort, I result with the array 2, 14, 8, 6, and 30. When I run a second iteration, I'm going to start with 2 and 14. Because these are in the correct relative order, I don't need to swap them. Then I move to 14 and 8, I will need to swap these. So I get 2, 8, 14, 6 and 30. Next I look at 14 and 6 and then I swap them. 2, 8, 6, 14 and 30. Now I look at 14 and 30 and I don't need to swap these because 14 is less than 30. But when we ran the first iteration, we made the observation that 30, the largest number, gets swapped to its correct position in the first iteration itself. Now that we know that 30 is the largest element and it's in its correct position, this won't get swapped in any of the further iterations. So when I run the second iteration like I did right now, I don't really need to compare the last two elements to see if I need to swap 30 or not. Let's look at another iteration to make this more clear. Now I have the array 2, 8, 6, 14 and 30. At this point, I know that 30 and 14, both of these numbers are at the correct positions. When I run the next iteration, I compare 2 and 8. These are in the correct relative order, so I don't need to swap them. I move on to 8 and 6. I need to swap these. So I get 2, 6, 8, 14 and 30. Then I compare 8 and 14, which are in the correct relative order. And then I compare 14 and 30, which are again in the correct relative order. Again, we notice that the last two elements, which were already in the correct positions, do not undergo any changes. We can use this fact to optimize our given algorithm. We can say that in any given ith iteration, I know that the last I minus 1 elements are already in the correct position. So I don't need to check if I need to swap them or not. Let's look at another example. Say I have an array 1, 2, 4 and 3. When I run one iteration on this array, I don't need to swap 1 and 2. I don't need to swap 2 and 4. Then I move on to 4 and 3 where the relative order is incorrect. So I swap these. I get 1, 2, 3 and 4. At this point, it's clearly visible that this array is already sorted. But because I'm running the naive bubble sort algorithm, I'm going to have to run 3 more iterations because I'm going to run a total of 4 iterations here because n is equal to 4. But the subsequent iterations are literally going to be redundant because the array is already sorted. Let's see how we can optimize this. When I run another iteration on this array, I don't need to swap 1 and 2, I don't need to swap 2 and 3, and I don't need to swap 3 and 4. Since the array was already sorted, all the relative positionings are correct. In the second iteration, I will see that there are no swaps required. If there are no swaps required between any pair of adjacent elements, I can say that the array is sorted and I don't need to run any further iterations. Let's look at the optimized algorithm that we can devise from the two observations that we have made. The algorithm will be similar to bubble sort algorithm, but we will make two more additions to the algorithm. In the ith iteration, instead of checking for all the elements, we are going to check for only n minus I minus 1 elements of the array because I know that the last few elements of the array have already been sorted. Secondly, we keep a check on whether the swaps took place during an iteration or not. As we looked at the previous example, in an iteration, if there are no swaps taking place, that means that all adjacent elements are correctly ordered with respect to each other, or in other words, the array is already sorted. If we encounter such a condition, we can declare our array as sorted, and we don't need to run any further iterations.